Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. I am a financial controller and a QuickBooks Pro advisor helping nonprofits to increase profitability one mission at a time. In this tutorial, I will show you how to create a sales receipt to track your external donations or track your upfront payments in QuickBooks Online. Use a sales receipt if you get your money right away. If a customer pays you upfront for services or products, you need to use a sales receipt to record that transaction in QuickBooks. This is also the best option to use if you are tracking donations or if you're tracking program fees or membership dues in an external donor tracking database system or CRM system. You do need to use a sales receipt to record the accounting component of that transaction in QuickBooks Online. To do so, you're going to click on the Quick Create Plus icon, then select Sales Receipt. If you are tracking your donations in an external system, you want to use a sales receipt to repeat the same process again in QuickBooks Online. So if you're using SurveyKeeper or Neon, you can create those external systems as a customer and then enter the lump sum batch deposit in one sales receipt. So if it's cash or checks, separate it out so you can enter checks first. Here I'm going to actually show you an example. If you are actually using Vanco system or like PayPal where they collect merchant fees, so here I'm creating Vanco payment solution as my customer, and I don't need to email this sales receipt out, so I'm going to leave the email field blank. My sales receipt date, I'm leaving that as a default. This is general donation, so I'm just going to switch my location to without donor restriction. I am going to select the online giving as my payment method. You could choose credit card if you want to. For the reference number field, I do recommend entering the ending batch date of the transactions that you're entering in QuickBooks Online. So if you get weekly batch report from Vanco or monthly batch report from Vanco, and if you're entering those transactions in based on how they occurred or based on how the funds were transferred to your bank account, enter that ending date as a reference number in the reference number field. Want to leave the deposit to as undeposited funds because you're going to record the merchant fees in the banking center. So you're not going to do the fees here. Here you're going to record the gross transaction. Under here and under the products and service line, you're going to create a products and service that is called tithes and offering or general donation or whatever you call your products and services. You're going to create one in the products and service line. Pause this video and go watch my product and service video if you have not done so. And this is a sample, so I'm just leaving everything as the default. In the description field, you can enter anything you want, such as online donations from merchant processors system. I am entering $200 as my amount and class is general fund. You can repeat the memo from the top and put it in the message display on invoice. In the attachment section, attach a copy of the batch report from the external system and then click save and close to save the sales receipt. To see a copy of the sales receipts that we just created in QuickBooks, click on the Sales tab at the left navigation bar, then select All Sales. Then click on the tab that says Paid within the last 30 days. And here you will see that the list has been filtered, and at the top you will see the John Foundation grant that we created and the Vanco Payment Solution sales receipt that we created. Thank you for watching.